welcome. Just a little bit of housekeeping stuff. We do upload, if you're registered for the video, we do send you the replay link, but we are also uploading these on YouTube, and we're creating some playlists in there. So I have a digestion playlist. I will have, this one will be in the neuropathy playlist. We will have stuff like that. And so you can also go watch them there. There we put the intros on them and all kinds of stuff. I'm getting better at this thing. It's my third one. The lighting on my face is still horrible. I rearranged my office so you could see me better, and I blocked the window, and it doesn't seem to have solved the problem. So, all right, so let's talk a little bit about neuropathy. Now, the movie that we're going to watch, I am going to be playing a movie. It's 40 minutes long, so it's long, but it's going to go into the actual problem with neuropathy. And the reason that nobody is getting any results with neuropathy is because they're not actually treating the cause of the problem, okay? The cause of the problem, as the movie will show, and we're actually, after the movie is over, we're going to actually show you the actual myelin sheath on the nerves. And that is where the problem is. It is in the myelin sheath. Now, I've been treating neuropathy for well over 20 years. We actually used technology that was, that came from from research that NASA did in the 1990s. NASA was trying to figure out how to grow plants on the space station, and what they were doing failed horribly. But for the blood flow and nerve conduction and things like this, it worked amazingly well. And so what this is pulsed infrared light. And then we were asked by the Cancer Treatment Centers of America to we kind of entered into some dialogue with those guys, because 9 out of 10 patients that have chemo, they wind up with neuropathy. So right across the street from my building here is a cancer treatment center. And it's not an accident I'm right across the street from them, because we do get a lot of business from them, just simply because chemo is very harsh on the nerves. But what we're actually going to show you today, and so what we found was the Cancer Treatment Centers of America were doing some things that we weren't doing, and we were doing a lot of stuff they weren't doing. And we started experimenting of combining what they were doing with what we were doing. And what we found is we even got a better result. Now, I'm a member of the Neuropathy Treatment Centers of America. We have about 100 centers across America. We have about 450 worldwide. So I'm not the only person that does this, but it's all about treating the actual cause, which fits with my functional medicine philosophy. Every chronic disease has a cause. And if we don't treat the cause of the problem, you know, a headache is not an aspirin deficiency. Okay. And a headache, aspirin doesn't do anything to the actual headache. It just blocks the pain sensor. So when I was a kid, my mom hated me. You know, I was one of these kids that asked 100 million questions. And I always wondered, you know, if I hit my thumb with a hammer or I crack my knee on the wall or the door or something, how did the aspirin know where to go? And as I got older and got into medicine and stuff, I realized that it didn't go to either one of those places. It actually went to the brain and just blocked the pain sensors. So the problem was still there. We just blocked the pain sensors. And this is what we're doing with most treatment with neuropathy. Okay. What we're doing is we're giving gabapentin or Neurontin or Lyrica or Cymbalta or something. And what we're actually doing with that is treating the pain, treating the numbness, treating the tingling, things like that. And it's never going to fix. I'm not against those drugs. If they're helping with the symptoms and improving your quality of life, that's great. But if we don't treat the actual myelin sheath on the nerves, we're never going to have any results with this whatsoever. We're just going to be taking drugs forever. And as the problem gets worse, the dosages of the drugs just continues to climb. So what we need to do is deal with the actual problem. And in this movie, like I say, it's 40 minutes long, and then we'll come on after the movie. And what we'll actually do is we will show you, like I say, some actual cross sections of the myelin sheath. We'll show you an artist rendition, and we'll actually show you the myelin sheath, how the myelin sheath is in the nerves. And you get a chance to see that, because this is what's going on. So the drugs are good for the symptoms. I don't have a problem with that, but they're not so good. Well, they're not even treating the myelin sheath at all. So
me ask you a question. Are you thrilled with your health? I mean, really happy with it? That's what's supposed to happen when you go to your doctor, but if you're listening to this, you might still be suffering with neuropathy. Statistically, 90% of neuropathy sufferers are relying on medications or injections to manage their neuropathy, but we all know that those are not the ideal long-term solutions. All right, how about another question? What if we could offer you a better way to treat your neuropathy, and it could improve your condition by 60 to 100%? Would you be interested in that? Neuropathy is a disorder of the peripheral nerves. Those are the nerves that go down into your arms, hands, legs, and feet. The peripheral nerves are anything outside of the central nervous system, which is just the brain and spinal cord. So the peripheral nerves, like the ones that go down to your hands and feet, are the ones that are affected in neuropathy. If you look on the right-hand side of the screen, you'll see three different types of nerves. On the top, there's a healthy nerve, and it has little blood vessels all wrapped around it. Underneath these blood vessels, you have what's called the myelin sheath. The myelin sheath is like insulation on an electrical cord, and your nerves need it to function properly. In order for that myelin sheath to survive, it has to be nourished by blood vessels like the ones you see in the picture. Looking at the middle nerve in the picture, it looks like it's starting to shrink. The constriction of blood vessels in this nerve decreases the amount of blood flow getting to the nerve, and it limits the amount of nutrients it receives. And eventually, if this keeps happening, it ends up looking like the bottom nerve, where it looks like it's dying off. This is exactly what happens in neuropathy. Peripheral neuropathy is one of the most common chronic conditions in the United States today. About 8% of the United States population suffers from peripheral neuropathy, which is about 24 million people and growing. Peripheral neuropathy can occur at any age, but it's most common among older adults. We've seen patients who have neuropathy who are from age 30 to 101. The most common cause of peripheral neuropathy is diabetes, and also idiopathic, which means the cause is unknown. But we can treat neuropathy that comes from many different causes. We don't only treat patients who have neuropathy from diabetes. Are you tired of taking medications? The truth is, most of us don't like taking a lot of medications every day, especially in the long term. They always come with side effects, and it's just not the ideal long-term solution to treat the underlying causes of your condition. The information we're going to share with you next might be a little scary for some, but we're trying to help you be informed about all the information you might need to know so you can make the best educated decisions. All the information we're about to present comes from the Centers for Disease Control and the World Health Organization, and you have a right to know about this as a patient. Bottom line, if we do the same things over and over again, we're going to keep getting the same results. We have a saying here in our clinic, if nothing changes, then nothing changes. This applies to both patients and doctors. The conventional approach to treating peripheral neuropathy goes like this. Prescribe medication. Wait until the condition gets worse. Then maybe increase the dosage. Wait until it gets worse again. Then maybe add in some more medication. Wait until it gets worse. And then pretty soon you have to add in the really heavy duty pain medications. This goes on and on until the patient is completely debilitated. And as a last resort, you have amputation. If you're taking medications like gabapentin, Neurontin, Cymbalta, amitriptyline, heavy duty pain meds, and you've been doing this for months, years, or even decades, what could possibly change? We've seen the trends for more and heavier duty medications skyrocketing, and we're here to break the cycle and take a different approach with our treatment program. Most patients are wondering at this point, okay, what's the alternative? How do I get healthy? Well, the good news is that the doctor who put together this program, it's his job, his mission, to fly around the country, attend conferences, read studies, and put together the best methods out there that have been proven for many years to help patients with neuropathy get better. These methods are helping thousands of neuropathy sufferers, and they're highly studied and proven, with methods outside of relying on medications, drugs, and surgeries. Your doctor has made a great choice to use this program, and you are in very good hands. This is our current medical standard of care. This picture comes from an article in a veterans magazine, and it describes our typical medical standard of care. It talks about that we have an epidemic in the U.S. We have a symptom care system, meaning that for every symptom, what do we have for it? Well, that's right, we have a medication. We have created a system that is fundamentally a reactive system, and it never looks at the underlying causes of our conditions. It just covers up the symptoms with medication. The article also talks about how we're in a health crisis in the US. For those of you that keep up with the news, you can probably agree that people are getting sicker and sicker in general, even though they have access to more and more resources around them to try to stay healthy. So why is that? The article also talks about how we have an insurance crisis. Our country's health is going in one direction, but insurance coverage is going in another. We've been bombarded with chronic illnesses, and there is no medication, injection, or surgery that will correct a chronic condition. Our healthcare system was originally built off of an acute care model, which means that if you get the flu, break your arm, or have a near-death emergency, that's what our healthcare system is best at, and that's also what insurance is for. Now they're trying to force chronic conditions into this acute care model, but it's miserably failing. What kinds of health conditions are on the rise today? And what makes up the majority of all doctor's visits now? Well, we have things like heart disease, diabetes, and even neuropathy. And these are all chronic conditions. Chronic conditions account for 75% of all doctor visits, which means that only 25% are for acute problems. Unfortunately, as we just discussed, our healthcare system is geared towards solving acute problems and not chronic ones. However, chronic conditions make up the majority of all doctor's visits today. You can see why we have a big and growing healthcare crisis on our hands. How much do you think we as a country spend on healthcare in 1 year? Usually at these seminars, we'll get some guesses with very high numbers, like $100 billion. Well, that's close, but not quite. We actually spend $3 trillion a year on combating these chronic conditions, but they're still on the rise. At some point, we have to agree that it's not the money we throw at these conditions that's going to help. It's the actual approach that we're taking that's going to get people better. We live in the wealthiest country in the world, and to spend this kind of money on healthcare could be a great thing if it was making people better, but we have to look at the facts, and it's just not making people better. Let's take a look at some more of these facts.
The American healthcare system is badly broken. The present system doesn't work, and it's going to take us down. We need a whole new kind of medicine.
We're in the grip of a very big industry, and it doesn't want to stop making money.
If I spend 5 minutes with you and then put in one of these stents, I would get paid $1,500. For me to spend 45 minutes with a patient to try to figure out what their true problem is, I would get paid $15. It's a completely irrational system.
We don't have a healthcare system in this country. We have a disease management system.
We're spending almost twice as much in America as any other country on earth, but our lifespan isn't even in the top 20.
30,000 Medicare recipients die each year from care they didn't need.
That's the equivalent of a jumbo jet crashing every single week.
If the aviation industry killed as many people, we'd be up in arms.
The administration pays you based on how many patients you see. All right, who's next? If you try and buck the system, someone says, what can you do to get your productivity up? I'm not interested in getting my productivity up. I'm interested in helping patients.
We're seeing the military just being a microcosm of the problems society's having.
Soldiers' use of prescription drugs has tripled in the past 5 years.
Medications I was on.
Only by accepting that the American healthcare system is badly broken will we be able to seek out the escape fires, the potential solutions. There are answers.
One company has figured out how to lower healthcare costs by more than 40%.
We provide incentives for people to engage in healthier behaviors.
The Army Surgeon General directed that we establish the Pain Management Task Force to take a look at alternatives to narcotics.
I was skeptical. So skeptical.
I've gotten a lot of inspiration, a different perspective. There's a different way of doing things that is possible.
If I think about what healthcare could be like, it would have a lot more care in it.
The healthcare system is unsustainable, we're really mortgaging the future. Not just the health of healthcare, but the health of the nation.
All right, let's lighten things up a little bit. How many washing machines are in the average household? Well, you might be surprised to know that the average home actually has two washing machines. The first one washes your clothes, and the second one, well, the second one is a brainwashing device. Did you know that by the age of 18, we actually see 2,000 hours of pharmaceutical drug ads? Usually they show something like a happy, healthy couple enjoying walking down the beach. But then in the background, there's always that soft voice that talks, sometimes for quite a while, about all the side effects that could come with the drug. The pharmaceutical industry spends $5 billion each year marketing products to consumers. The incentives are all aligned for them to create drugs that you have to take for the rest of your life to manage your condition, not to cure it and get off the drugs. We make sure to check in with our patients about a plan to get off the medications they're currently taking. Most doctors never even talk to their patients about this at all. We've had patients come through our clinic who have been taking their medications for months, years, sometimes even decades, and some of them didn't even know why they're taking them anymore. Coming up next, we're going to show you a commercial for a common medication that's prescribed for neuropathy. But notice the long laundry list of side effects at the end. The first 30 seconds of the commercial is about what the drug does, but the last minute is all about the side effects.
Hi, I'm Terry, and I have diabetic nerve pain. I worked at a patrol unit for 17 years in the city of Baltimore. When I first started experiencing the pain, it's hard to describe because you have a numbness, but yet you have the pain like thousands of needles sticking in your foot. This progression would be getting worse. And at that point, I knew I had to do something. When I went back to my healthcare professional, that's when she suggested the Lyrica. Once I started taking the Lyrica, the pain started subsiding.
It's known that diabetes damages nerves. Lyrica is FDA approved to treat diabetic nerve pain. Lyrica is not for everyone. It may cause serious allergic reactions or suicidal thoughts or actions. Tell your doctor right away if you have these. New or worsening depression or unusual changes in mood or behavior. Or swelling, trouble breathing, rash, hives, blisters, changes in eyesight, including blurry vision, muscle pain with fever, tired feeling, or skin sores from diabetes. Common side effects are dizziness, sleepiness, weight gain, and swelling of hands, legs, and feet. Don't drink alcohol while taking Lyrica. Don't drive or use machinery until you know how Lyrica affects you. Those who have had a drug or alcohol problem may be more likely to misuse Lyrica. Ask your doctor about Lyrica today. It's a specific treatment for diabetic nerve pain. To hear more of Terry's story, visit Lyrica.com.
Did you know that one of the most commonly prescribed drugs for peripheral neuropathy is not even designed to treat peripheral neuropathy? Generally speaking, about 20% of drugs are prescribed off-label. Off-label means that the drug is designed or approved for one condition, but it's used for other conditions. The use of gabapentin or Neurontin has become so widespread that as many as 90% of prescriptions are for off-label uses, such as the treatment of peripheral neuropathy. Speaking of Neurontin or gabapentin, it's not actually FDA approved for neuropathy treatment, even though it's commonly prescribed off-label to treat neuropathy. The FDA approved gabapentin for seizure disorders. The way the drug works is by calming down neurons. That's why it's effective for seizures, because a seizure is too much activity of neurons in the brain. It also happens to work for neuropathy by calming down the nerves as well. As the dose increases, so do the calming effects on the nerves, but also so do the side effects. A normal dosage for this drug would be about 300 milligrams or maybe even 600 milligrams. Above that, you start running more risks in terms of side effects. But we commonly see patients in the clinic who are prescribed 2,400 milligrams, 4,800 milligrams. We even talked to a pharmacist locally who saw someone who was prescribed 7,800 milligrams of gabapentin every day. You have to ask yourself, are the benefits and trade-offs worth it for those high dosages of drugs that could potentially run the risk of huge side effects as well? Don't forget that each medication is accompanied by a whole host of potential side effects, some of which can be quite negative. We're not going to tell you not to take medications. Of course, there's a time and a place for them. You need to be able to take the edge off so you can go to work, enjoy time with your family, go on walks, or even you might need them to be able to sleep at night because your feet feel like they're burning when you're in bed. If that's the case for you, then please, by all means, keep taking your medication until you figure out a solution. That's what we're here for,
We're trying to provide a solution that's going to work for you in the long term and actually addresses the underlying problems that are causing your neuropathy. This article from Medline Plus brings up a really important point. This is a study showing that there are more people killed by prescription narcotics than cocaine and heroin combined. Today, prescription medications are the third leading cause of death, right behind cancer and heart disease. Let's switch directions and talk for a minute about how we treat our bodies. Did you know that we sometimes treat our bodies worse than we would treat our car? Well, if you don't believe me, let me ask you a question. If you were driving in the car and your check engine light came on, what would you do? Well, you'd probably take it to a mechanic. They would pinpoint the internal problem and then they would fix it. And then the light would go off because the internal problem had been fixed. What if I were to tell you that the last time my check engine light came on when I was driving in my car, I took the car to the mechanic and just asked him to reset the light for me so it didn't bother me anymore? Well, that doesn't make sense, does it? Yet this is exactly what we're doing with our pain. When we take medications so the symptoms go away, we never address the underlying cause. Once the medication wears off, the pain or other symptoms just come back. The next time you experience balance problems, burning in your feet, electric shock-like pain, if you feel squishy on the bottom of your feet, like you're wearing socks when you're really not, or if you have cramping or sharp pains, understand that all of these signals are your body's check engine light coming on. This is a warning from your body. It's like your alarm system is going off. If you ignore this warning, and going back to the check engine light analogy, it would be like if you reached into your glove box and just put a Band-Aid over the check engine light so you don't see it anymore. Well, what's going to happen if you do that? Well, the internal problem is just going to grow and grow some more, and finally it will reach a point of no return. This is exactly what we do with our health. As we said, there's a time and a place for medication. We have to work, we have to enjoy life, but putting a bandage on neuropathy is going to get you into a situation with a point of no return. Eventually, you won't be able to walk. You're going to start falling. Eventually, it might get so bad that it's not even treatable anymore. Imagine for a minute that you have a plant, and you see that your plant is wilting. What might you do to get the plant healthy again? Well, maybe you might think it needs something, such as water, maybe more sunshine, or maybe even some nutrients like fertilizer. Those are logical things to think about when we see a wilting plant. If adding things doesn't work, well, maybe the plant has bugs on it, or maybe it's planted in some bad or toxic soil that might be causing it to be unhealthy. The same principles apply to your body and your health, especially when it comes to neuropathy. We have to give your body everything it needs in order to work properly. We are a living organism just like a plant, and we have certain requirements that we need. We have different types of nerve fibers for different things. Some of them sense pressure. Some of them sense the position of your feet relative to the ground. Some of them sense vibration. Some are for cold, some are for hot. Some are for light touch, and some are for heavy touch. Neuropathy usually starts in one foot most of the time. Sometimes it starts in both feet. You might have symptoms for 2 days of the week, and then it will progress up to 4 or 5 days out of the week. It might still only be in one foot, and then it will go into the other foot, and then it starts going up your leg. Neuropathy will progress slowly for about 2 to 5 years, but then at a certain point, it will get dramatically worse, and at the end of that drop-off point, it is no longer treatable. We try to reach people and help them before this drop-off point so that their neuropathy can be treated successfully. Now let's go over some of the ways that nerve damage from neuropathy can affect your life. One of the types of nerve fibers that's commonly affected with neuropathy is the large fibers. These control balance and coordination. This can lead to big problems because if you start losing your balance and coordination, this could lead to falls. We have millions of nerve endings in our feet and legs that communicate with our brain for position sense. If I'm wearing a blindfold but I can still balance, I know that I'm not relying on my eyes for vision. It's actually my feet and legs communicating with the brain. When sensory nerves start dying off, our position sense starts dying off as well. You might get up, then have to stop and regain your balance before you start moving again. Or you might have to take shorter steps, called shuffling. Or you might start naturally looking around you for things to grab onto so you don't fall. This continues to get worse and worse until you need a walker to stabilize yourself. Falls are a major concern because they definitely increase the frequency of injuries. This is why we're so serious about helping people with neuropathy. Falls are no joke. They really put lives at risk. One out of every three seniors experiences a fall every year. 20 to 30% of those who fall suffer moderate to severe injuries, including bruises, hip fractures, or even head traumas. 10% of all falls are fatal. Falls are the leading cause of injury and death among adults over age 65. However, less than half of seniors talk to their healthcare providers after they experience a fall. Another type of nerve fiber that gets affected in neuropathy are small fibers. These are the fibers that feel pain and sharp sensations. The problem with this is that patients don't know when they cut or injure their feet. We've seen patients come in with deep cuts, even broken toes and other foot injuries that they didn't even know they had because of their neuropathy. Small fiber damage can also lead to symptoms like numbness, tingling, pinching, sharp, deep stabbing sensations, and electric shock sensations. There are 80,000 amputations performed every year in the United States, and peripheral neuropathy is the number one cause of amputations in people with diabetes. What happens in these cases is we have decreased nitric oxide and VEGF in the bloodstream, which leads to decreased blood flow to the nerves and skin. Decreased blood flow to the nerves and skin means longer healing times. Then, if you get an infection or an ulceration, it can lead to gangrene, which leads to a situation where you have to amputate to save the person's life. Another common type of damage with neuropathy is C-fiber damage. C-fibers let your brain know the temperature of your feet. Sometimes you might feel freezing pain, or you might feel like your feet are on fire, even though they're in normal temperature. This is caused by C-fiber damage and neuropathy. Okay, so if you have neuropathy, what are your choices? Well, in the conventional medical system, you have two different choices. One is you can go to your primary doctor and you could get drugs to mask the symptoms. And your second choice is you could get referred to a neurologist or a specialist. And then maybe you get some specialty tests done, but you get the same medications in the end. The medications don't change based on which doctor you go to, so it's pretty limited in terms of your choices. Some people say that the definition of the word insanity is doing the same thing over and over again and expecting different results. If nothing changes, then nothing changes. And that's totally true for our health and the way we approach treating chronic conditions like neuropathy. You may have heard this before from doctors. If you've ever been told that there is nothing else that can be done and you just have to live with it, well, we're here to tell you today that that is absolutely not true. Dr. Neil Barnard says in this popular book that you can reverse diabetes, heart disease, even neuropathy, and we completely agree. In fact, the doctor who designed this program has been saying that for years. Chronic conditions can be reversed. You just need to know how to put the body in the optimal position to heal itself. Once it's there, it knows exactly what to do. We use some writing in our program from a doctor who says something very similar, but it's specifically geared toward peripheral neuropathy. So what's the answer? Well, we need to help the body heal itself. This thought process has been around forever. Here's a quote from Thomas Edison, who had over 1,000 patents and discoveries. He said, "The doctor of the future will no longer treat the human frame with drugs, but will rather cure and prevent disease with nutrition." Well, that's an interesting quote. And it's an idea that we've lost sight of over time as we've come to rely more on drugs, surgeries, and injections, none of which actually cures chronic conditions. Do you believe that the body can heal itself if given the proper tools? We restore nerve function and health by healing from the inside out. We take a comprehensive approach to treating peripheral neuropathy, and we see the best outcomes as a result of addressing the body as a whole. A critical and unique part of our treatment plan involves a series of comprehensive treatments that put the body back into an optimal position to heal itself. The body knows exactly how to heal itself. Sometimes it just needs a little help. Now, if you're a little skeptical, if you're wondering whether that's really true, that the body knows exactly how to heal itself, let me give you an analogy. Let's say someone breaks their arm and they need to get a cast. Does the cast heal their arm or does their body? Okay, let's say that someone cuts their hand and needs to have stitches. Do the stitches heal the cut or does the body? Well, right. In both cases, it's the body that's healing itself. Sometimes it just needs a little help. The cast and the stitches are just putting the body into the right position to heal itself. That's what we do with neuropathy. We do a lot of research. We go out and look for the newest cutting-edge technology to treat neuropathy. We found that if you attack neuropathy from every angle and leave no stone unturned, that about 85 to 90% of our patients get great results. Let me tell you what great means. For example, that would be like if you had 60% nerve loss and you could restore most of that function, taking you down to about 10 to 20% loss. If your pain was diminished from a daily nuisance down to nothing, if your numbness got better, if your balance got better, and most importantly, if you're able to do the things that you had to stop doing because of the condition, would you consider that a great result? Since we're talking about putting the body into an optimal position to heal itself, let's go back over the pathology of what's happening in neuropathy one more time. Up top, you see a picture of a healthy nerve. The nerve fiber is on the inside, and on top of it, you have the myelin sheath that protects the nerve. And then you have a lot of little blood vessels on the outside, which are supplying oxygen and nutrients to the nerve. Now, if everything that's pictured below that top picture is representing different stages of neuropathy, we need to get some new blood vessels going so they can supply the damaged nerve with blood, oxygen, nutrients, and everything it needs to thrive and heal. Let's go back to the plant analogy. If a plant is wilting, what would you do? Well, you'd give it water, sunlight, and nutrients. That's exactly what we're trying to do with your nerves. We're trying to get new blood vessels and more blood to nourish the nerve back to health. So let's dig into what that means. Neuropathy is a condition that requires a multi-pronged approach to treat all the damaged areas. We found that a four-part therapy regimen we've developed really works for treating neuropathy, and each part is just as important as the others. Now let's talk more about each of the specific parts of our program. One element in our treatment toolkit is called low-level light therapy. Low-level light therapy is the use of near-infrared light to stimulate a process called angiogenesis. Angiogenesis is the creation of new blood vessels, and new blood vessels around a damaged area are exactly what it needs so it can start to heal. This is an example of what angiogenesis looks like. At the top, you see a nerve with very little blood supply. But after angiogenesis occurs, you see a huge network of blood vessels, which is exactly what the nerve needs to repair the damage. Here is a real picture of angiogenesis. On the left, you see a nerve with barely any blood vessels. That's the control. On the right, you see a picture of a nerve with a lot of blood vessels after treatment with laser or low-level light and VEGF, which is a protein that stimulates angiogenesis. You have this in your body, too. There are thousands of studies on low-level light therapy that support its safety and effectiveness. Light therapy can reduce pain, improve immune function, speed up wound healing, speed up the healing of fractures. It increases the production of DNA and collagen, the building blocks of tissues, and it increases the activity of fibroblasts, which are the cells our connective tissue is made of. All of those things are necessary for wounds and injuries to heal. Low-level light therapy has been FDA cleared for treatment. The second part of our treatment plan is re-educating the nerves. When nerves get sick and start dying off, they forget how to work properly. So we have to basically rehab them and teach them how to function properly again. We use a 21st century technology that's being used in all the cancer treatment centers of America. The reason they do this is because chemotherapy can also damage nerves. They get great results with this, and so do we. This is different than a TENS unit, which you may have heard about before. TENS units are just for pain management, but we use a more advanced and updated technology to actually re-educate the nerves. Our patients love it, and they get great results with it. We speak the language of the nerves. What does this mean? Well, we use low-level light therapy to stimulate angiogenesis. We use a cutting-edge digital electrotherapeutic stimulator to help the nerves stop hurting and retrain them to function properly. And a lot of this is done right in the comfort of your own home, so you can get your healing started in a convenient way. The third part of our treatment regimen is a nutritional protocol that's developed specifically for neuropathy. There is a natural vasodilator which opens up the blood vessels. It's called nitric oxide, and you need this to keep the blood flowing in those tiny little blood vessels that nourish the nerves. However, increased amounts of sugars and starches actually decrease the efficiency of nitric oxide, and the typical American diet is full of these high sugar and starch foods. This, of course, leads to decreased blood flow in those tiny little blood vessels that those nerves rely on for their nourishment. sugars and starches can also create inflammation in the body, which further acts to decrease blood flow. We address all of this with our nutritional protocol that's specifically designed to treat neuropathy. Don't worry, there are thousands of patients that do this every day. It's easy to follow, it's fun, and you can totally do it. Your blood vessels are like tiny pipes. When you decrease the size of a pipe, less can flow through it. When blood vessels are given the proper environment and assistance with natural levels of nitric oxide, now they become dilated, meaning that the interior of that pipe is expanded and more blood can flow through it. This is what we want, because we want to bring more blood flow to those little nerves so that they can get the nourishment they need to heal. We give our patients some natural products that help the body produce more nitric oxide. The idea is that this is going to lead to more dilation of the blood vessels and more blood flow to the areas that need it. The scientist that discovered the importance of nitric oxide in regulating blood flow actually won a Nobel Prize in 1998. We found that we really need to take a comprehensive approach to treat neuropathy. It can't be done with just simply a medication or an injection. Because there are so many factors that contribute to peripheral neuropathy, we really need to take a holistic approach to treat it. Some of the things that we do to treat neuropathy include light therapy, which stimulates angiogenesis, electrotherapy, which is going to repair and re-educate the nerve, our metabolic management programs for blood sugar monitoring, and also working on your balance and your joint health. All of these elements come together in our comprehensive neuropathy treatment program. When we evaluate patients in our clinic, we put together a tailored program that's just for them. We determine how many clinic visits they might need and what their at-home care protocol might look like to get them better. Now, let's hear from some of our patients about their experiences in our neuropathy treatment program.
After going to two other different places for treatment for my neuropathy, I came here, and after a lengthy discussion with Dr. Gum, I decided this would be the place to come for treatment, which I've done. After 31 visits, I'm about 90 to 95% cured, and I am very fortunate that I came here.
I came in with a severe neuropathy. I've been somewhat skeptical about coming here. I've been in the healthcare business for 45 years, but after increasing doses of gabapentin and having made no real progress, I came here. After two treatments, I was able to sleep at night. Very shortly after that, I was back to my neurologist, and he was so impressed that I reduced my gabapentin by half, and now I'm down to a quarter of what it was when I first started. He's seen continuing improvement in both my feet in terms of endurance, walking, and standing.
And let me begin by saying that over 5 years ago, at the age of 80, I was told by a well-respected neurologist that I had peripheral neuropathy, and that at my age, I probably had it for quite some time, and that there was nothing they could do for me other than to take B12 and be very careful that I do not fall over. Well, to my surprise, Dr. Gunn, after testing, I thought that he could really have the potential of giving me some help. And here I am now in my 8th week of therapy, and the results have been amazing. I no longer have the tingling and the pain sensations in my feet. My balance has become just drastically improved. And on top of all of this, the greatest thing is that I'm sleeping better at nights. I wake up in the morning fully refreshed, and psychologically and mentally, I'm just feeling a great deal significantly better.
I was having pretty bad neuropathy in both of my feet, and it was continuing to get worse. After seeing the medical doctors, they really couldn't do anything for me but give me some pain pills and some vitamin B12 shots. And it continued to get worse, and so I decided I need to do something better, be proactive. And I saw the ad in the newspaper, so I came to get tested. Sure enough, I was in pretty bad shape. I have considerable improvement. I'm down to maybe one incident a week. Right now, I would have been coming for 3 weeks. I was having 5 or 6 incidents a day start, so it's helped a lot. The diet has helped a lot with the anti-inflamed diet, the deflating diet. I'm losing, I probably lost about 7 or 8 pounds already, and feel better and have completely changed what I'm eating, because I was eating all the wrong stuff, and I've already cut back on some of my diabetic medications with seeing my doctor. It was okay with his blood work and stuff, and also on my GERD stuff, cut my Nexium in half already.
My feet have been dead for quite some time, and I got concerned because two different times in my pickup, I had my foot on the accelerator instead of the brake, and I almost ran through the carport. So we started the treatments. About 3 to 4 weeks into the program, I noticed that after I'd done my home treatment, I could feel the carpet when I was walking. That's the first time I've done that for quite some time. So continue to see improvements. I think I had only about 15% feeling in my feet when we started, and halfway through the program, they checked me, and I was up to 60%. So it's been very helpful. It's made me feel better, more confident in my driving, more confident in my walking.
What is your motivation? Why do you want to get healthy and reverse your neuropathy? Your motivation in this process is going to be our motivation. So we'd like to ask you to think about that for a moment. It could be that you want to be able to play with your grandkids, maybe go on a walk again with your loved ones, or maybe you just want to have the ability to take care of yourself without relying on anyone else. With our health, we really only have two directions we can go. You could be moving toward greater health, or you could be moving away from it. No matter where you're at right now, it's never too late to improve your health or your well-being. So who should come to see us? Well, it's really very simple. If you have the symptoms of neuropathy, come see us. It would be silly not to go through our process to see if we could help you. If you have any of these symptoms, numbness, burning pain, cramping, sharp electric-like pains, prickling or tingling, if it hurts when you walk or you have balance problems, if you can't sleep at night because your feet hurt, you should come see us. Let's find out if we can help you. We are looking for two types of patients that we accept into our program. Type one is people who are all in with their health. They value health. They want to live longer to be with their family. They want to be productive. They want to perform their best in life. And they just generally want to thrive in life and with their health. Type two are exactly the same as patient type one, except they might fall off the wagon here and there. And that's okay, because our team is here to help you and support you and get you back on track. Who should not come to see us? Well, that'd be patient type number three. If you are looking for a quick fix, or if you don't want to take the time or aren't willing to invest into your health, then you would not be a good match for us. We are looking for patients who want to be an active participant in the process. We are extremely confident and competent in what we do. We don't take recommendations from outside sources. Our programs work as long as you commit yourself to them. And if you make that commitment to yourself, you are going to get great results. So what should you expect when you come to see us? Well, first you'll get an application for admission to our program. You'll receive a consultation. Your practitioner will go over your health history and give you an exam, and then they'll present you with a report of their findings. When we evaluate our patients, we have a 16-step evaluation process that helps determine what kind of nerve fibers you have that are damaged, exactly what kind of treatment you'll need, and how long it'll continue. We want your spouse or significant other to be a part of this process. Neuropathy is a serious condition. We want them to understand your condition and what it's going to take to get you better, so we can all sit down and make a decision together to see if you're a good candidate for our program. We have a specific process that works, and it includes your significant other being a part of the decision process. If you weren't coming to us through a webinar, a seminar, or a free pre-education consultation, the cost for your initial evaluation and consultation would be $249. Since you came today, and we only have the evaluation process to do, it's only $49. At this time, insurance questions sometimes come up, so we like to be very upfront and transparent with our potential patients. Let's go back first, though, and talk about the two different types of conditions that we spoke about at the beginning of this presentation. We have acute care, where there are drugs, surgeries, and injections used, and that's commonly what insurance covers. The problem is that neuropathy doesn't need an acute care approach because it's not an acute care condition. It's a chronic condition, and as such, it requires a systematic approach to get outside of the drugs, surgery, and injections paradigm so you can get better. Please do not wait and let your neuropathy get worse. Neuropathy is a progressive condition, meaning it gets worse over time. We are here for you. You're in great hands. The practitioners who are using this program really know what they're doing, and they're going to help you get the results you want so you can get back to living your life. This next video really makes it clear that there are two paths for your health. Either you're moving toward greater health, or you're moving away from it. I'd like you to think about that as you watch it. Where would you like to be?
What will your last 10 years look like? Will you be quick enough for a game of tag with your grandchild? Strong enough to embrace every moment? Will you grow old with vitality? Or get old with disease? It's time to decide.
Hopefully you can hear me again. I just plugged my microphone back in. Now it talked about $49. If you're watching this, even if you're watching it on YouTube, we do this exam for free. We don't do it. We don't charge money for it at all in our clinic. Other clinics may, I don't know. But we do it because a lot of people don't qualify for this. People that don't have the type of nerve damage that our treatment works on well, and they're just not going to work well. So I don't think it's fair to charge you money and then tell you I can't help you. So we in our clinic, we do it at no cost for you. So if you're watching this, whether you're watching this here on YouTube, wherever, and you would like to get that, at the end of this, I give you my email address, my telephone number. Take advantage of this. I tell people our intro exam takes about 45 minutes and that's all you have to lose. I mean, what's the worst thing that happens? You come in, we do the exam, and I tell you it's not going to help you, you know, and I'll be brutally honest with you. And we have well over a 90% success rate with this treatment plan. Our average improvement is probably somewhere around 70 to 80% better is pretty normal. Some people get more, some people get less. That's why it averages to 70 to 80. Last year I had 3 failures. So failures are very rare also. And the reason is that we're very, very careful who we accept into the program. If I think it's going to work for you, I want to offer this to you. If I don't think it's going to work for you, I don't want to offer this to you. I don't want to get your hopes up and then it not work. So, but this right here is a picture of the myelin sheath. So what happens is a lot of times you'll see it and it will be, they will call it axonal damage, okay, because the axon is the part of the nerve that the myelin sheath is on. Now, this is a myelin sheath, okay? All these little things are myelin sheaths. Now, the nerve is right here. The nerve is the actual nerve part, which is inside that myelin sheath. When I went to Gross Anatomy, I was unbelievably disappointed. Because the nerve's about the size of a piece of thread. It's really, really small. Your spinal cord is about as big around as your little finger. I mean, it's unbelievably small, and it runs your whole body. It was just incredible. So this is the myelin sheath, and this is the part of the nerve that allows the nerve in your big toe to communicate with your brain basically instantaneously. And it's the myelin sheath, and that is the problem in neuropathy, okay? The myelin sheath is the problem in the neuropathy, and if you're not working on the myelin sheath, it's not going to work. You can block the pain or block the tingling or something like that, but it's just going to keep getting worse. And so what actually happens with this, and the other thing sometimes people don't know, restless leg syndrome is exactly the same problem. Now, it manifests completely different. Restless leg is made worse when you don't use your nerves, whereas neuropathy is made worse when you do use your nerves. But guess what the problem is to both of them? The myelin sheath, okay? So this is an actual picture of a cross-section of a control, a person who has normal, and a person who has SFM, small fiber neuropathy. Now, each one of these black things is the myelin sheath, And this is a normal nerve. This is what it's supposed to look like. And when you have small fiber neuropathy, this is what your myelin sheath looks like. Okay, and this is the actual problem that is going on in neuropathy. And what's actually happening is the myelin sheath is deteriorating. And as the myelin sheath deteriorates, the nerve cannot communicate well with the brain. That's why we get balance problems, because the brain relies upon the signal from the feet or the legs or whatever's going on to tell the brain, I'm leaning to the left or I'm leaning to the right, and then it makes the appropriate correction. But when we don't have that feedback, right? I mean, the feedback from the patients was from Dr. Gum. He's the clinic that we actually used to test this whole system. And, we found that we're actually, when we combined what the Cancer Treatment Centers of America was doing, what we've been doing for over 20 years, we actually improved the success rate. And what happens is, here's a little secret. In my clinic, I treat neurologists and podiatrists, because they know what they're offering you doesn't work. And so when they get this problem, they come in to see me. Now, they'll never admit they're here, and they'll never refer me a patient ever. But this is what's going on. And so if you don't work on the myelin sheath, you have no ability to fix this problem. Now, you can cover up the symptoms, and as the problem gets worse and worse and worse, and pretty soon you're shuffling around, pretty soon you're using a walker, pretty soon you can't drive anymore, pretty soon you can't walk anymore. And then what happens is you basically either have to have somebody in your house that can take care of you, or what most Americans do is they go to an assisted living care. And so I always tell people, we're not talking about neuropathy. What we're talking about here is independence. We're talking about your ability to live in your household for the rest of your life and take care of yourself. That's what this is about. This is about you being self-sufficient. This is about you being able to get to the grocery store to buy food for your house and stuff like that. And so if you're frustrated with neuropathy or restless leg, like I say, they're both treated exactly the same. You know, I have a nurse that works at a hospital locally here, and we treated her, and she had horrible restless legs. She would even have to get up and walk around the table if she was in a meeting, because she couldn't sit still for more than 10 minutes. And we got her probably about 80, 85% better, and now she can sleep, now she can sit through meetings. And I know we think of these things and think, well, what's the big deal? It's a big deal when you get affected. I had a patient, I thought this was just amazing to me. They traveled all the time, and she was having to stop the car. Her husband would have to stop the car, and she'd have to get out and walk around the car about every 30 minutes because she just couldn't sit for any longer period of time. And her husband was an engineer, and what he did was bought a big van, and he put a stationary bicycle in the back of the van. So when she needed to move around so she could keep her legs from giving her all kinds of problems, she went in the back of the van and rode the stationary bike so they could stay on the road. Why don't we just fix the myelin sheath? If we fix the myelin sheath, we can actually fix the problem, right? Because that's the problem. And nitric oxide, not nitrous, but nitric. And nitric oxide is what improves, it causes vasodilation, and it improves the actual blood flow to the myelin sheath, which allows it to repair and recover. And that's really what we're talking about. And then the other technology that we use is, it's called the Rebuilder. Now, this is different. You can go online and you can find a Rebuilder, but this is a different version of the Rebuilder. They have a commercial one that actually you just work in medical offices with, and then they have one that they sell to the public. So there is my email address and our phone number here, and you don't even have to live in Tucson. That's the amazing part of this new therapy. That with the new therapy, we can treat people in other states, other countries, because the equipment is now sent to you. You don't have to come into the office. You own the equipment, and you can treat yourself as many times, 7 days a week, 3 times a day, 50 times a day, whatever you want to do, because you own the equipment. And when we used to have to do it in the office, of course, if you didn't live in Tucson where I'm at, you didn't get care. It was just that simple. But now we have branched out. We've worked deals with companies that we can actually send the technology directly to you. And we have a deal with the supplements to increase, from a biochemical point of view, the nitric oxide to increase the circulation to your nerves. So thank you for listening to me. Let me unshare my screen here so that we can actually take any questions if you have any questions. So in that Q&A box, you can write any questions that you have. And what I would like to tell you is, one of the doctorates I have is a chiropractor. And how I got involved in this is I did everything they taught me to do in chiropractic school for this. And guess what? Nothing helped. So I also have somebody told me, well, you need to be an acupuncturist. Those are the guys who fix the nerves. And so I became a licensed acupuncturist. The problem with being the acupuncturist was it worked. It helped the symptoms for sure. But it didn't last. It was like taking a drug. It did help the symptoms, but it didn't repair the actual nerve fiber. Now, this was way before I knew anything about the myelin sheath and all this kind of stuff. I also have another doctorate in naturopathic medicine, and I did everything they taught me to do for neuropathy, and it didn't work either, right? And then I took some classes from a medical school, kind of a diplomate program that taught me just about what to do for neuropathy, and guess what they taught me to do? Drugs, gabapentin, Neurontin, Lyrica, Cymbalta, things like that. And again, that wasn't what we wanted. And so we sat down about 25 years ago, and we actually, when we started looking at the cause of the problem, is when we first started to have some real success with this program. This is about treating the cause. I mean, I'm also certified in functional medicine. That's not what we're talking about here. But the reason I got into functional medicine is about the cause. Everything is about the cause. If we don't deal with the cause of the problems, we have exactly no way to do it. What exactly is the rebuilder? The rebuilder is a new technology that we are just starting to use. And it sends a little microcurrent through the nerves. So once we actually help the myelin sheath, which is what we're helping with the pulsed infrared, which is what's based on the research done by NASA. That light is what they were trying to use to build, to grow plants on the space station faster. It didn't work, but it helps with blood flow. It helps with the myelin sheath. Well, what we found out was some of the people, once the nerves got bad enough, even though we repaired the myelin sheath, that nerve conduction, the signal that goes down the nerve, it just wasn't coming back. And so this is something that the Cancer Treatment Center of America was using that we weren't. And it's called the Rebuilder. And like I say, you can go online and find a Rebuilder. It's very different from the one we use. But what this actually does is once we get the myelin sheath better, then we have to sometimes start sending signals down that nerve again to like retrain it to be able to send those signals again. So that's the rebuilder. So very different, Barbara, very different from the boots. The boot is the pulsed infrared. I always call it a boot. It's a big pad, but I call it the boot because I fold it and kind of make it like a boot. But it's very different. It's very different. This is what we added through the Cancer Treatment Centers of America. And they were doing this part and we weren't. And we were doing a part they weren't. And so we kind of combined it. And Dr. Gum, that's the testimonials that you saw, he combined it and he was using this for our clinics for about a year and a half before we ever really got involved in it because we wanted to make sure that it was going to work. We've been told over the years about this works and that works and this works and that works. And we try it. I mean, we'll try anything because I don't care what we do. What I care about is that you get your quality of life back, that you get your feeling back, that you get the pain gone, the numbness, the tingling gone. That's what we're about. And we try most of this stuff, and 99% of the time, it doesn't work at all. It just doesn't. I mean, I was in Australia teaching neuropathy one time, and this guy comes up to me, and he says, oh, we got this gel that just works on neuropathy like there is no tomorrow. He gave me a couple of bottles of it, and we tried it. It didn't do anything. I mean, so there's a lot of stuff out there, and we have to make sure that we test this kind of stuff. And what we do is test it internally way before we ever offer it to our patients, because just because one doctor can do it doesn't mean everybody can do it. Right. And so what we do is one doctor does it. He brings it to the group. Then the original five, there are five of us that have been involved in this since the very beginning of it. I just happen to be one of those five. And we do it for the next year, make sure that we can get the same results that the original doctor said. And then if we can get the original results, then we have 100 of our doctors do it for the next year. And this is kind of, we don't have the FDA checking this stuff out. So what we have to do is we have to actually have our own internal system to make sure. Let me read you something. This is scary. A treatment plan that seeks to prevent a disease, promote the patient's health, prolong or enhance the quality of the patient's life, or a therapy that is performed to maintain or prevent the deterioration of a chronic condition is not medically necessary. This is Medicare's guidelines 2251.3. This is in the Medicare guidelines that if this therapy will promote your health, prevent a disease, improve the quality of your life, or maintain or prevent the deterioration of a chronic disease, we're not going to pay for it. So what Medicare and insurance will pay for is they'll pay for the surgery to cut your feet off. They'll pay for the wheelchair to push you around. They'll pay for somebody to push the wheelchair around, but they won't pay for the therapy that prevents all of that from happening. It is time to change our healthcare system. And this is what functional medicine is doing. This is what programs like this neuropathy program. We are going after the cause of the problem, fixing the cause of the problem, or at least improving the cause of the problem. It doesn't always fix from 100%. And then we're giving people back their quality of life. And this is what functional medicine and neuropathy treatment, this is what it says. We are the quality of life doctors. The medical profession is excellent at keeping you alive. I always tell people, if I get run over by a truck today, do not take me to a functional medicine doctor. I want you to take me to the ER. I want to get my bones put back together and I want some pain pills. But I don't want to be on those pain pills a year from now. And one of the principles of functional medicine and with our neuropathy, we want to teach you how to keep it this way for the rest of your life. We're not interested that you keep coming back to us. That's not health. We want to give you the tools so that you don't need us. So one of the principles of functional medicine and neuropathy program is to teach you to need the doctor less. So I'm running over a little bit. I apologize for that. But this is brand new stuff. We've used a program that we've been using for over 25 years, and we've combined it with some stuff that we learned from the Cancer Treatment Centers of America to create one program. And we're getting even better results than we've ever gotten before. So if you have neuropathy, I don't care what state you're in. I don't care what country you're in. Neuropathy, restless leg. You call me or send me an email to that email address that you saw. Or give me a call on the phone, and we will figure out if this will help you. And if this will help you, this can radically transform your life. So any other questions, type them real quick. If not, we're going to sign off. And like I say, if you signed up for this webinar, you will get the replay link very quickly, probably by tomorrow, by the time I get it all uploaded and everything. And then we also will make it all pretty and everything. And then we will, I guess I'd have to be eliminated from the video to make it all pretty, huh? But we'll make it all pretty and put it on the YouTube. So it will be there also. But I got to figure out the lighting. I'm still really dark. My face is really dark. So I got to figure this out. But every month we do this. Oh, next webinar, next month. Why everything that you have been taught about cholesterol is wrong. Okay? The rules keep changing about cholesterol. They just keep changing, right? So attend next month's webinar. It's on my website, TucsonFunctionalMedicine.com. Under About Us is Dr. T's teaching schedule. We have the entire year's webinars already scheduled, already ready to go. And below each one of the webinars is a little link that you can click, and you can go to the March 8th is daylight savings time. Yes. So what happens is we don't change time. So we change the time. So some of the times are Pacific time. Some of the times listed on when the webinars are is mountain time. Right now we're mountain time, but in the summertime we go to Pacific time. So it changes depending upon where you are. So yes, Peggy, we definitely do change that. And we did update that on the website, but every one of the webinars, so I believe it's the 11th of next month, I think. I'd have to look. I'm not positive. In the PDF handouts, we'll also send you a link to the PDF handouts, will be the flyer for next month's webinar. Tell your friends about these webinars. We are really trying to raise the awareness of health and real health, not patching symptoms, but real health. So thank you, Peggy, Barbara, for participating. I love this. I've been giving teaching for years and years and years. Webinars are really hard for me because I don't have any people that I can see. And so I don't have anything to feed off of. And I've been teaching for a long time, but thank you for that. I got to get off. I've run a 5 minutes over and I apologize that. But thank you for coming. See me next month for the one on cholesterol. Thank you. Bye-bye.